When you think of carnivore, what do you think of? Most think of a lion, or maybe you thought of yourself. However, plants can also be carnivores. Weird, huh? You've probably heard of the Venus flytrap, but did you know that there are many other plants that are carnivorous as well? You probably have a lot of questions. How did these plants evolve to be insect-eating monsters? When did they start developing carnivorous behavior? What are the specific genes that allow plants to be carnivorous? And most importantly, why are these plants carnivorous? That's what we'll be talking about today. Before we get into the video, we should talk about how plant carnivory actually works. For example, in the well-known Venus flytrap, the plant produces a sweet-smelling nectar in order to attract insects. When an insect comes into contact with one of the hairs on the inside of the leaf, the trap closes loosely at first, then very tightly. The reason for it not immediately closing tightly is that the plant allows small insects to fly back out of the trap so that it does not waste its energy on digestion of an insect that doesn't provide sufficient nutrients. Also, to avoid expending unneeded energy, the plant hormone ABA is responsible for making the plant less sensitive to mechanical stimulation by inhibiting the effects of a certain stimulating hormone. Similarly to the secretion of enzymes in the human stomach, the plant then secretes digestive enzymes such as chitinase to break down its food. The secretion of these enzymes is induced by the plant hormone jasmonic acid.
Like you, there was a group of scientists that was asking these questions. So they decided to investigate the genomes of several carnivorous plants to see what genes they shared and how these adaptations came to be. Basically, they obtained carnivorous plants from a nursery and isolated their DNA and RNA to create things called gene libraries, which is a collection of all of the genomic DNA from a single organism. They then changed specific genes and annotated them, and then created models for their genes they found.
With this process, many corresponding genes were found between these carnivorous plants. There were 10 genes specific to the pitcher plant that encoded dihydropyrimidinases, which are essentially responsible for recycling nitrogen. There were genes that regulated development that are related to adaxial and abaxial polarity, or upper and lower sides of leaves. These had higher expression in pitcher leaves than flat leaves. In the flat leaves tested, genes were more related to photosynthesis than the genes found in the pitcher plant. Pitcher leaves demonstrated leaves that encoded for more starch and sugar metabolic processes, called sucrose biosynthetic genes. These genes were upregulated, basically meaning that they were transcribed more. The genes that encoded for the slippery, waxy epidermis were predominantly found in pitcher leaves. These were even duplicated in the genome of carnivorous plants. When a plant body ingests molecules, they must be absorbed into the plant body. Certain transporters of these digestive molecules were expressed more in pitcher leaves, like the ammonium transporter.
With this data, these scientists created phylogenetic trees to determine relationships between these seemingly evolved genes found in varying carnivorous plants. It turns out that the four carnivorous plants studied divergently evolved from a common ancestor, yet the genes for carnivory emerged in later generations of the plants, as seen in the phylogenetic tree. Plants previously used symbiotic relationships with bacteria and fungi to obtain nitrogen through nitrogen fixation mechanisms. However, in multiple species with multiple origins, the pathways for the development of carnivory were similar in all species and display convergence. This is relevant because the corresponding genes from species with multiple origins show that there are limited routes to carnivory, an application which we may be able to use to explore biodiversity across different species. We can infer that the reason for these different species of plants all coming up with the same solution is that they live in similar environments. Because plants have limited ability to survive in nutrient-poor ecosystems, the development of the process of catching insects and consuming them proves to be a vital adaptation.